That is right. We are gonna go with the gun blade. Nasus top, right? Nasus top. Let's start with the Doran's ring. We're gonna have a tiny bit of a mana issue here. I probably should have started with the Sapphire Crystal to get a Tear Goddess. They don't have any magic damage dealer other than probably Nasus tiny bit from E or Nami. So we don't have to grab magic resistances. The Hourglass is somewhat useful. We'll go Gunblade and some mana item. Teemo really doesn't have any good mana item other than Tear Goddess. Let's do Tear then. Ninja Tabite? Nah, we're going Mercury Treads though. We still need a Mercury Treads because we're facing a Nasus. His Wither has to be avoided by using a Mercury Treads plus a Phase Rush. I'll try not grab the Hourglass this game, and we can work on the tier later stage. You don't have to grab the tier early. Teemo surprisingly stacks the Tear of Goddess faster in the later stage of the game instead of a early game. And that's when you need really the tons of mana anyway, so. I'll show you guys when to grab the tier. We usually grab the tier around like after the first item complete. Wow, he's got some perfect CS so far. Impressive, Nasus. So once again, we usually go smite Teemo versus Nasus, but this game I didn't go smite because I did not know who I was gonna face. I actually thought that it could be a Vayne top with a Nasus mid lane. So against the Vayne, it's better to grab an Ignite because she's an easy kill. And at the same time, we still need a Phase Rush if we ever get to face Nasus. So we grabbed both Phase Rush and Ignite. Against the Vayne, any of the runes pretty much works. I think the Electrocute is probably the best though. But if we ever get to face Nasus, then Phase Rush is like always must. Because once again, the Wither. Vayne takes the first death, and then Ash takes the second death, and V takes the first death from our side. So surprisingly, it's an Ash mid lane with a Vayne 80 Sight this game. I guess we must expect the Lee Sin to be heading to topside with Nasus, because we didn't take our blue the top lane, you know, I mean top jungle. Nasus here, Lee Sin should be coming nearby. Let's back up. He's not coming. All right. Just a few CS's doesn't allow me to get a Mercury Treads. That's alright. We'll go with the Vampiric Scepter. What they call it? Vampiric Scepter allows us to have some tiny bit of sustain against Nasus in the early. In. I'd never get a Nimbus over the mana flow. Teemo has a big mana problem with usual build. Yes, you're right, but at the same time... Actually, you're right. I should've got to mana flow bend this game. Let's go mana flow bend next time. Because we don't really get to use a Nimbus clock much with having an Ignite Flash. I'm used to grabbing a Smite with this build, so... Usually with the Smite, Nimbus clock is good. But with this specific like Ignite base rush one... like you said, mana flow bend would've done better. No, never mind. I think I'm right. Yeah. Because there is also a possibility the Nasus can have a Nimbus clock with the Ghost Flash. In those cases, if you don't have a Nimbus clock against him, you'll just die. Yeah. Yeah, I just remember now. So against the Nasus, always Nimbus clock. Getting chunked a bit.
An ally has been slain.
Blinded him right before he gets the cannon mania. He missed that too. Where did our Nessus go?
An ally has been slain.
In my opinion, the best Nessus runes and summer spell would be a Ghost Flash with the Unsealed Spellbook. Yep. Against the Teemo, that is. For some of you guys who main the Nessus, go try grabbing like that. Then you will have a chance to kill the Teemo. You don't really need a Grass Undying or Conquer. Yeah, you don't really need like damage runes. All you need to do is lock the Teemo down and just be faster than him. You don't even need a damage item, that is. Yeah, you don't even need a Sheen. Go like a Spectre's Call of Mercury Shred and just... I'll whack the Teemo down.
Armed and ready.
One day, if I get to play a Nasus versus Teemo, I'll show you guys how it goes. Thank you. And with the Unseal spellbook, you can occasionally have the teleport up by swapping it. And sometimes use the exhaust, sometimes use the ignite, sometimes use the heal, barrier. You can pretty much use anything on Masters to make it work. Starting to dealing some damages, Nessus. Did I just get ganked by an Ash? What the? What in the world?
Yes, sir.
Oh, now you're coming, Top Ash? Is that what it is? Fine. Oh, she's been getting a pretty good CS. So 91 CS to 50 CS. So she's ahead by 40 CS. And so am I ahead by about 60 CS. Ooh, Nasus got to kill in the mid lane. Oh, Nasus! Nasus! Double kill! Impressive. Ah, you saw me. Alright, fine. She does damage. Looks like her arrow was on a cooldown. Ash with the T-Pie is known to be like, you fire the arrow from the base and then T-Pie onto that spot. So she can fire the arrow from the base to me right now and then just T-Pie onto this cannon turret, I guess. So as she T-Pies comes in and then arrow hits me, it's pretty cool, but usually never really works that well. Why are you taking my CS, this guy? What about your bot lane? Uh oh. This doesn't look good, guys. Bites. Looks like we gotta go to the bottom lane, right? Let's get a double dagger with these. Well, Ari, you're going bottom? What is this? I'll go bottom. I can also take the red. Is red up? Yeah. Ash is here. Oh, bro. Wait, she's strong. Unexpected. Oh, nice buy. Oh my gosh, she was strong. Kill it! Yo! Bro? What is this shit? Bro. Okay. All right, team. All right. Team it is. Don't worry. I got my plan. If you have a shitty teams like this, you get the fuck out of my CSs. Take everything. Mm-hmm. That's the only option. Take every single CSs, camps, and everything. You just gotta funnel yourself and then do the 1v9. That's the only option. That's the only option that we have right now. Yes, sir. Yeah, Philly was trolling. That was a kill right there that he could have had. Just let it go. He wants some attention. Do not worry about them getting our turrets. Only worry about your farming. Just keep farming. Do not stop the farm. It doesn't matter if four of your teammates are dying, they're taking a Baron, it doesn't matter. All we need is farming. This is like basically only trust yourself. Do not trust anyone. Now I want you guys to take a note on this because quite a lot of people ask me about this. Wait, if your teammate is a shit like this, how do you carry? This is the only way to carry. If your team cannot handle the 4v5, then it's pretty much game over. But they usually can by the time that they get to the Nexus turret. Enemy team starts throwing. Yeah, I'm not getting that turret. Fuck that. Carry it. They actually got it. Trini Force Vein. I don't mean it. Jesus Christ. That was a big mistake. Can you steal it? So bad. At least Aphelios is doing something. I need a blue buff. Yo, I feel you. He did something. No, what the fuck? How are you taking my come on, man! Jesus Christ.
Reporting in.
Oh, looks. They tried to backdoor this. GG's! So that's how we call it the game. good job, good job, people. I had to kind of try hard, guys. I'm sorry. I don't usually try hard, but I knew we had this ADC and I'm about to report. Should I report him? Or should I just let him go? I'll just let him go. Okay, judges.